Most lessons in science class are meant to give students a look at the world around them.
We are gathering all our data.
For these middle school students at Lincoln K-8 district-wide school in Rochester, this lesson is both science and health.
It's stuff that comes from vape juice.
Students take the embryos that come from these zebrafish and in a petri dish like this, add a diluted amount of vaping additives like flavors. The amount the embryo gets is equivalent to or even below what a human would consume if they vaped.
The zebrafish allow us a window into development that we don't see in other model systems.
Chris Purette is a director of the Inside Out Foundation, a partnership between Rochester Schools, the Mayo Clinic, and others, and helps the students with their experiments. He says because the zebrafish develops quickly, it allows the students to study the effects the vaping solution without nicotine has on the embryo in just days.
The tail?
Those effects.
The structure is not normal. It's really not.
Showed up quickly.
We've learned that the heart rates have been usually lower than the control.
I hope that the students walk away with a voice. They found out about vaping, not only how vaping might affect development, but also how they, as students at the target market age for vaping, are responding to knowing more deeply about it.
A science lesson from which everyone could learn.
If a teacher is just telling you don't vape, that's bad for you. And when you compare it to this, our actual research about it, you show this to kids, they might actually think, wow, that might actually be bad for me.
In Rochester, Jennifer Austin, Care 11 News.
Well, the students follow national guidelines for testing on animals, which minimizes harm done to the zebrafish.